Want to fill up your masterclass? I'm going to give you 3 tips to help you fill up your masterclass with quality leads. First, let's remember, we're doing this masterclass or challenge to get clients, get paid clients. It's not for us to just have an audience for us to perform, right? So it's important that we get quality leads, because people who sign up or even come to your masterclass doesn't mean that you're gonna make a sale. And those who sign up as a courtesy in the DMs don't really turn into clients. So that's why it's important that you get those quality leads. We haven't met yet, so I'm Karma Hunter. I'm a brand mentor and a conversion strategist. I help online coaches create their flagship offer and plan their launches with evergreen systems and strategies so that they can scale to 10K months without social media burnout. Honestly, my first launch was a disaster. I had 4 people come, 2 of them were my friends, and 2 of them were people just there for the freebie, and they didn't even stay until the end. Now, that didn't stop me. I didn't quit. My next launch was 9K. And now, with the launch plan I designed, me and my clients make 5 to 10K and have a conversion rate up to 70% every time we launch an offer. And that's why I wanted to share with you 3 tips today that will help you get quality leads to your masterclass that will turn to clients. And let's talk about what a quality lead is first. A quality lead does not mean a potential client. I repeat, a quality lead does not mean a potential client. You heard it right. A potential client could be anyone. Look, when you say, I'm a wellness coach, everybody needs health, and everybody needs to be well and health. They need health. They need to be healthy. Or you say, like, I'm a mindset coach, I can help any woman, and everybody needs mindset. True. So they're all potential clients. And the meaning, the definition of a potential client is a client who is having the capacity of turning into something in the future. Right? So when you look at it that way, everybody is a potential client. They can be all nurtured into turning into a client one day. But what you need is the probable clients. Probable, meaning that it is likely that they will turn into a client. A probable client is an intentional client. They already have the intent. They already have the motivation to turn into that client. So those are the ones you need in your masterclass. The best way of doing this is to put your leads through a qualification process. And how do you do this? Tip number one, content strategy. Now, when I mean content strategy, I don't mean how many times to post, when to post, where to post. I mean what you're saying in your content. That needs to be aligned with your offer. During your launch campaign, let's say it's a month launch campaign period, what you talk about should be different than what you're talking about in the regular time that you're not in your launch season, in the launch campaign. So align that content to show why they need to be in this masterclass or challenge. So the ones that are going to be signing up are going to be those people who actually know what they're getting out of the masterclass, and there's a reason why they're signing up. Strategy number 2, very important, your landing page. Now, more important thing is how you're getting people to sign up. Are you just asking for their email address and signing up yourself? No, that's a no-no. It is important that you have them sign up themselves. One of the mistakes I'm seeing on the landing pages is that you're talking about your vision, your mission, your everything, right? No, just talk about this one single masterclass and the challenge that they're signing up for, and what are they gonna get in this masterclass or in this challenge. And help them sign up, like make them sign up and make that decision to sign up. Then they're more intentional, right? When they're signing up themselves, if they understand what they're signing up for, obviously. Don't worry about a pretty design of the landing page. Call out your ideal client, tell them what they're getting, give them the opt-in form. That's it. And tip number three, is reminders. Make sure you have reminders. Just because people signed up doesn't mean that they wanted to. Number one, sorry. Number two, doesn't mean that they're intentional to really come join. Doesn't mean that they're not busy. Doesn't mean that they won't forget. Doesn't mean that they're not thinking about, oh, I'll watch the replay instead and fast forward it, right? So reminders are very important. If they sign up a whole month in advance, make sure at least weekly send them some type of relationship building email. Not necessarily saying, hey, you have a masterclass in a month. Within the week of the masterclass, send them a reminder. The day before, the day of, an hour before, and a 15 minute before. And the day of reminders, hour before and a 15 minute before reminders, must have your link for them to join the actual class. There's a very, very important bonus tip for you. This is gonna help you increase your conversion rate about 20% if you do it right. A lot of you guys get kind of discouraged because you couldn't sell as many offers. You didn't get as many clients out of your launch. And then you shut down. This is a fact that you convert more clients after the live launch event. And I'm gonna tell you how. And don't just send the replay video. Don't just send those bonus are expiring or discount is expiring emails, but send them an email sequence that is gonna help them make that decision. If they were on the fence, they're gonna come to this side of the fence. If they didn't even watch the video, the replay, they will wanna watch the replay and make a decision, right? These decision-making email sequence. If you want a cheat sheet, I have a cheat sheet showing exactly what you need to talk about in the email sequence. I'll just drop it to your email DM, and no email or opt-in required, just for me to say thank you for watching this video. And yeah, thank you for watching this video.